doing?
I was waiting. You're home.
I'm afraid to ask how long you were waiting.
I don't know. A while?
It's so cold in here. You didn't turn on the heat? Are you trying to save electricity or give yourself hypothermia? You look like a human cocoon.
Do I? Don't worry. I'm fine. My legs are a bit numb from sitting, though.
Don't look at me like that. I didn't ask you to wait for me. You're my sister, not my pet dog.
I was lonely.
Well, that's not my fault either.
So, how was your day?
You look pretty tired.
I'm fine. I just had school.
My chemistry teacher assigned a lot of homework.
Right. You always do. Will you be home tomorrow, or do you have to go to school?
Tomorrow's a Saturday.
Oh! Right, sorry.
At least try to remember what day of the week it is.
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
So, what'd you do today?
Me? Well, I woke up this morning when I heard you leave. After that, I slept some more and went online. Then I got hungry, so I ate some bread.
You even put ketchup on your bread!
I toasted it this time, though.
Impressive.
Well, I did, and after that, I don't know. I felt lonely, so I thought I might wait until you came back.
It was so cold. So you decided to take all the clean blankets out of the closet?
I'm sorry.
You could have just turned the heat on.
I promise I'll put them back. I'm sorry.
Stop apologizing. It's fine.
I'm home!
Dad!
It's so cold in here. What are you doing with those blankets?
Nothing.
All right. Yeah, you got it, something. Especially nice. Ta-da! We need sushi tonight. See you, Mira? It's your favorite. せーの、いただきまーす。
いただきまーす。
Here you go, Mira. I know you like eggs the best.
You don't have to baby her. She's 15, only a year younger than I am.
What's wrong with a father taking care of his daughter? You know, it's so nice when all of us sit together like this.
Are you forgetting we're a family of four?
Well, your mother's working late again tonight, so we might as well be a family of three. I'm the one taking care of Mira and you.
So you're the one taking care of everything. Where were you today?
I was busy.
But you don't have a job.
Stop talking like your mother.
But everything is about her!
No, it isn't. She acts like I'm some freeloader, but do you see her here, sitting with us? Does she act kind or caring towards her hikikomori, her shut-in daughter? No, she doesn't. But I do. I do more than she does. And she thinks she's so much better than I am.
You said that she's a shut-in, but sometimes I don't believe it.
What?
I think she leaves the house.
Really? Does she?
Yeah, I heard her. My room is next to hers and the walls are thin. She was leaving the house at night through the window, no less. What kind of hikikomori does that?
That's great!
That's great? That's all you have to say? You're not, like, worried?
Well, it's good if she's going out at all, day or night. That's improvement. Besides, this is a very safe neighborhood. I don't see the problem.
Oh, I see her problem.
I don't really want her to go outside.
Yes! No, that's not what I meant.
Listen, right? Why don't you go do your homework? Let me be the parent.
fall in love for the night and forget in the morning. Play me a song that you like. You can bet on every line. I'm the boy that your boy hoped that you would avoid. Don't waste your eyes on jealous guys. Stop that noise. I know better than to call you mine. You need to pick me up. I'll be there in 25. I like to push my luck. So take my hand, let's take a drive.
Hello? What? I told you. It was not my fault I got fired by that son of a... Are you forgetting the fact that I'm dealing with two children at home? One of which is permanently at home? If you know, then why? No, I'm not wasting my time. Well, we both know it's not my time you're worried about. It's your damn money.
Closest to us.
You're so unconvincing.
I'm not lying.
He just did. Twice. Where do you go?
I went to the store just once. I promise.
You are a pathetic liar.
What do you want me to say?
The truth?
I just wanted
Is that
to...
so unreasonable?
I
Yes! It's so unreasonable for me to act this way when my sister is sneaking out at night. My little sister who's supposedly incapable of leaving the house at all? You're pathetic.
But
you can't even step out the front door.
I just
and you lie when the delivery people ring the door. And you don't eat or sleep like a normal person, even not to mention you only watch yourself twice a week!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I'm so pathetic. I'll shower more often.
Dear Mira, I was thinking of you all day today, after I walked you home last night.
I can't believe it. She has a boyfriend? What? October 3rd. It's over 1 month ago. Is this the first one?
Dear Mira, since we don't see each other often, I thought I might write to you. There are so many things I want to tell you. You're amazing. It feels strange leaving you letters at your window, but I understand why. Thank you for coming to see me yesterday. It made my day. I'm sorry that you had to get wet on our last date. I didn't expect it would start raining. But you were so beautiful, drenched head to toe. I started reading the novel you recommended. I see why you like it. The main character reminds me of you. Shy, but funny and courageous.
What is she now?
Last night was amazing. I'll never forget it for the rest of my life. I only wish we could have stayed together. At least until morning.
Ew, gross!
It's starting to get cold lately. I know you're at home most of the time.
Well, like all the time, except for when she's sneaking out of her window to see you.
But please, take care of yourself and stay warm.
Damn right she should. The last one is from only a week ago.
Dear Mira, this is my last letter to you. I don't think we should see each other anymore.
What? You're breaking up with her now? Why? That's so sudden.
I can't be with someone who will only see me at night.
Whose fear of the public is greater than their love for me.
What are you doing?
Then I got lost in thought.
That sounds like something I would say.
Whatever.
Many hurtful, unforgivable things. But I wanted to tell you that I didn't mean any of it. I love you. I love your kind, thoughtful personality. I love your sense of humor. I love everything about you. All I want is to see you one last time, if you'll still have me. I'll be waiting outside your window next Wednesday night. Sincerely, Kenji.
She'll know it's me. She's definitely leaving me out here to freeze on purpose.
Who are you talking to?
So you know that I...
Why don't you come in? It's cold out. I knew it was you.
I'm sorry. I mean, I was just trying to help. I was going to tell you, but I knew you wouldn't take it well. I didn't want to lie to you, but I had to.
I wouldn't recognize your handwriting?
Well, yes. I mean, no.
You didn't recognize my handwriting?
What?
Those letters.
Yes, I read them, the love letters.
I know. I wrote them. That's my handwriting.
What?
There's no way somebody like me could ever be in a romantic relationship with another person. Not with the anxiety I have.
I'll explain.
So please, don't laugh at me. I wasn't lying when I said I went to the convenience store. Kenji, he's a part-time worker there, but I made up that name, Kenji. I don't know his real name. I don't know him at all. I don't even know what days of the week he works there, just that he does night shift. At first, I just wanted to see if I could do it.
Do what?
Go outside. I didn't want to meet people, so I went at night. The first time, I was only out for a few minutes, but the second time, I went down the street to the convenience store. That's where I saw him. From the moment I saw him, I liked him. He looked nice. He had a nice face. I started imagining what it would be like if we were together, and I started thinking about it all the time. But that just made me feel even more lonely. So I started writing those fake love letters.
Did you ever talk to him?
No. I wasn't able to talk to him at all. I never could. I just stood in the corner. People always thought I was weird. One time, I tried to get his attention, but when he looked at me and asked me if I needed anything, I was paralyzed. I felt so guilty. I wanted to die. I felt like I did something criminal, writing those fake love letters, lying to myself. It was unbearable. So I just ran away. Once I got home, I wrote the last letter.
And you've never seen him since?
I haven't been out since. Even though I'm a hikikomori, even though I'm so afraid of people, I always feel so lonely. I wish I could be like everybody else, be in a big, bright world with friends, school, and crushes. But I can't. So instead, I created this pathetic fantasy romance. Thank you for writing the letter. It made me happy reading all the kind things you wrote. I love you too.
Hey, you want to go out with me?